Hey everyone, it's your favorite hip hop DJ, Fae Fae. Very big shout out to Adidas. Big shout out goes out to Sports Scene for the merch. And of course, a huge shout out to The Weeknd Turn Up. This is my episode. Yeah. People that know Fae Fae know that I used to be a pageant girl. Growing up, I was very tomboyish. And then in high school, I got into pageants and I was a very, like, you know, pageant queen type of babe. So when I started DJing, I was that girl that was always wearing dresses, cocktail dresses and high heels. But eventually got to a point where I needed to be more in tune with the hip hop culture in terms of the way I dress and the way that I look. So I decided to become a sneaker babe. Thank God for Adidas. So I cut myself these cute little pink numbers. They're the Adidas Original Women's Forum Bold pink sneaker, and they're super comfortable. I like them because they make me taller. So shout out to Adidas for these pink numbers. Fae Fae, my original name is Faith Makubung. I'm from Limpopo. I grew up in Pretoria in Centurion. Yeah, I've always been like a suburban girl until I went to university in UJ. And I remember when I had the option to choose a campus, I picked Soweto campus. I could have picked Auckland Park, but I went for Soweto campus because I wanted a real culture shock. And I got it. I really got it. And that's basically where I dibbled and dabbled in radio for the first time. I always wanted to be in radio. I remember back when Y Academy was still a thing, I used to always apply for Y Academy, but I was not old enough, obviously. But when I got to UJ, one of my friends who's in Korea right now, and she's living there, she actually was like to me, dude, let's go audition for UJ FM. They were having auditions on campus throughout all four campuses. So we were at Soweto campus. We went to audition, and I remember she wanted to be a presenter, and I was like, I'll do something easy where I can read. And I opted to go for the news anchoring because I could pronounce the names. Unlike in sports, some people's names, I really just didn't want to butcher people's names. So I auditioned for the news anchor role, and I got it. And I think that was like when I really first realized that I don't have to necessarily be a model, because when I was in pageants, it was that thing of, oh, after you do pageants, you can still do modeling work. Then I realized when I got into radio that, oh, how you look is great and all, but actually how you sound, you can get further from speaking on air and actually being very knowledgeable as a pretty young girl. So that's when I really just took it upon myself to learn the radio game. I was fortunate enough to have a personality where I could get along with people. And I remember I made friends with the music director at UJFM, and that in itself helped me to get a little bit more of a broader perspective of what radio is about. And my journey with UJFM started there and it didn't end there. Flexing every time I'm making runs on these stupid sides, my money, I prefer to make it bigger. Just another diamond in the dirt, what a business. My passion project has always been empowering other women. And I think everywhere in my life, somehow the universe conspires to make sure that, like, I work with women. And I always take that opportunity and I run with it, because if anything, as women, we're very competitive and we have this little jealous streak. And I'm trying to kill that narrative to say, instead of pitting women against each other, if we actually came together and worked together, maybe we would achieve more. Because the whole idea is to give female DJs a platform so that we're consistently being seen as way makers in this industry.
Back today, she won my attention. Tell me, why is yours expensive? Yeah, time that I extended just to focus all on you. Still, you might go missing if I can't give you
100%. If anything, this year I want to learn how to produce. I know how everyone is just like so caught up in, like, oh, I want to release my own record, I want to sing, I want to rap. And surely South Africans have put a lot of pressure on us as DJs because they think that we are the hit makers, which is so crazy how things have changed. But I personally definitely want to make my own music. I've had a lot of offers, and you guys can keep bringing those offers in until obviously I decide and fold. But my whole thought process with regards to making music is, first of all, my music needs to be hot. Secondly, it needs to be genuine and it needs to be very organic. Like, I'm trying to be in this for the long haul. So if I'm gonna release music, I don't wanna feel pressure to release an album when I just wanna release a project. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna release music. I need to learn how to produce first so that I can actually have a proper input and not just have my name on a record, which is what's happening around here. And I also want to put on women. Like, I feel like as much as I'm doing the whole female DJs, when I start making music here, trust and believe, the biggest records in this country are gonna come from some of the women. Like, yo, dude, I don't even wanna get into name dropping, but you know what I'm saying. This right here, this little number right here that I'm wearing, is the Adidas Original Women's Multicolor Dress, right? And it's nice and short. I would stand up so you can see, but you'll see. And it's a turtleneck. The nice thing about it is you can actually zip it down and open it so you can show off your chest area, which is for me. However, it is winter right now, so I'm trying to keep warm. But yeah, I love this dress because it's a long sleeve, it's nice and short, and it's nice and tight. Everybody knows you can never go wrong with a good body contour. And as a woman, the Lord giveth and he hath giveth you, and it's important for you to show off those assets, right? So this dress, it was one of the few things when I walked into the store I saw, and I was like, this is cute. It gives me like expensive brand vibes. So when I felt the fabric, it was super comfortable. It's got like a really like it's almost like a knitwear type of dress. So with me being in the nightlife all the time, as a girl, you always have to look really pretty. Like, it's one thing to come to a gig looking average, and then it's another thing to come to a gig with your hair done, your nails done, and looking like hot to the T.
You don't have to worry about no Bianca.
Yes, I do. She my girl. She my girl, bro. That's a life.
First of all, no.
That's a life.
James,
that's a life. That's a life.
Right now, I'm currently working on a super dope project, which is my birthday tour. I kickstarted it off this past weekend at Booth Nightclub. I'm doing 7 parties. I've done one. There's 6 more to go. So check out my social media at DJ Fae Fae to see the rest of the parties. And then the rest of this year, I'm working on women hosted events, right? So I want to bring ladies together. I want events where women are able to showcase their talent and it's run by other women so that no other girl can come back and say, oh, this guy did this to me or this man did this. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to keep the energy nice and clean. You know how Beyonce said girls run the world? We really do run the world. And I think this year is my opportunity to really put women on that center stage.
You can call me dumb, but my number's dumb. 07 Tipas on top of Tipas, oh, na 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 na.
Hi everyone, it's your favorite hip-hop DJ, Fae Fae, and thank you for watching my episode on the Weekend Turn Up. A very big shout-out to Sports Scene, as well as Adidas for hooking me up with the drip from head to toe.